Street clothes are taken care of, but you've got to organise some more.
Mm, yeah, I know. I'm going to need some of your measurements.
Oh, yeah, we can get you a complete set from the panto stuff.
Now listen, you need transport, ready and waiting.
Right. If you're not driving yourself, I need, for God's sake, get someone reliable.
Don't worry, it'll probably be me. But I've got good contacts anyway, just in case.
Now, so far, you haven't said anything that would cause us to halt proceedings.
What's this?
Oh, let me see it.
It's from Megan, from Western Australia. See, I told you the truth all along. You can see here where she mentions the money and how she gave it to me.
Yes, I can see that. Wow, that's a stroke of good luck, isn't it?
Yes, I'll say.
That sounded fascinating. What was it all about?
Yes, apparently Anne Griffin's friends come good in the nick of time. She wasn't in service. She was in Western Australia. And she's admitted that Anne is innocent. She gave her the money.
This is the letter from Western Australia. Came yesterday?
Yes.
From a Megan character.
Well, that's right. I didn't see it.
I did see it. I censored it.
What's wrong?
Well, the letter I censored wasn't from Megan. It was from Griffin's brother, and it stated that the family had disinherited her. Griffin gave you a letter, supposedly from Megan Evans.
That's right. We're going to try and trace her by the sender's address.
Well, if you'd asked me, I could have saved you the trouble. You know all the prisoner's mail is censored. Well, the only letter that Griffin has received while she's been in here was from her brother in Western Australia.
Are you sure about that?
Yes, of course I'm sure about it. I can even tell you what the letter said. It said that her family were disinheriting her, but they were sending a lawyer named Collins to handle her case.
Is this the letter?
Well, it's the envelope. No. The paper was much better quality. It had a sort of a crest on it. I think we'd better go back and have another word to Miss Griffin.
Strange that a family should disinherit her and then send in a lawyer.
Yes, they're probably trying to keep their names out of the newspaper.
Hey, Bea, when do you think we ought to make the break?
Will you shut up? We're walking down a corridor and all the doors are open. Who knows who might hear?
I know, I never thought of it.
The trouble with you is you never do. How are you going to cope on the outside? I don't know.
What's going on? Has your bail money come through?
No. I've had a letter from Megan telling me where she is. When the police talk to her, they're bound to let me go.
How do you know she'll tell the truth?
Oh, why shouldn't she?
She ran out on you, didn't she?
No, she didn't. She just went to Perth. She didn't know I'd been arrested.
So who told her?
My family.
What are you women doing in here?
Just saying our farewells.
Well, you should be in the laundry. Come along, move it. Come with me, please, Griffin. You won't need that. The police want to talk to you again.
And even after what Miss Bennett has told us, you still insist that this letter was written by Megan Evans.
Yes.
Nonsense. That letter was from your brother.
There was a letter from my brother, but Megan's letter was in with it. Megan's very forgetful. My brother probably thought that if he didn't put her letter in with his, she'd forget to post it.
If this Megan told your brother you were innocent, how come he's disinheriting you?
He isn't.
That's what it said in the letter.
He said he was sending me a solicitor.
And that he's disinheriting you.
He didn't.
Where is your brother's letter now?
It's personal. I don't see why I should have to show you.
Is it possible that there was a second letter in the envelope and you missed it?
No.
Miss Bennett is very thorough.
Thank you, Mrs. Jackson.
If Megan didn't write the letter to me, who did?
Obviously, you wrote it yourself.
Aren't there experts who can tell whether somebody wrote a letter or not?
Yes, a graphologist.
Well, show them the letter.
Very well. But we'll need an example of your handwriting to compare it with.
That's real good, Helen. If you just write my name like that, you can take it to the bank and I'll give you the money.
You reckon? You know, though, I never thought I'd be much good at forgery.
Oh, yeah, it just takes practice.
Yeah.
Hey. Nelson and Irene, they want to come with us.
Oh, good. You're not exactly taking the brains of Wentworth with you, are you?
Yeah, but what's it matter anyway? We'll be splitting up when we get out.
Yeah, you'd need to. You wouldn't stand much chance with that little lot. Not that she'll stand much chance on your own either. Nor will she.
Yeah. Well, after what she's been through lately, I think she has a better chance on the outside, huh?
How's the escape plan going?
Oh, good. There's another one.
Between you and Doreen, you might just as well put it on the 6 o'clock news.
What did I do?
Oh, nothing, except the two of you can't keep your bloody mouths shut. I wouldn't be surprised if the screws knew about it already.
Neither would I, seeing who's involved.
Are you accusing me?
Who else? I mean, anyone who'd steal from their mates would do anything, wouldn't they?
Oh, yes. Come on, cut it out. Instead of fighting amongst yourselves, what you should be doing is trying to find out who really took that money. Then you'd know who couldn't be trusted.
If you really didn't write that letter, then there's nothing to worry about, is there?
Isn't there? Well, what if they don't find Megan in Perth? That letter was posted 2 days ago. She could be anywhere in the world by now. Well, what if they don't find her before my trial?
Is that why you forged the letter, to give yourself time?
I didn't forge it. The handwriting test will prove that. Oh, you're just like all the others, trying to trick me.
No, I'm only trying to help. Now, Miss Bennett said that that letter wasn't in the envelope when it arrived.
Well, she's wrong. Either that or she's lying.
Now, why would she do that?
To get at me. Everybody's trying to get at me.
You know something? I reckon the best time to get down that manhole is going to be at night.
Oh, come off it. And how will we get you out of your cells? I can see us getting one out, but not four.
Maybe if we all stood around that manhole cover, we could shield them from the screws.
Oh, now that's a terrific idea. They wouldn't suspect a thing, would they? All of us standing around like lemons while four of us disappear.
Well, we could look innocent, chat and smoke.
Oh, come off it, Lizzie. What we need is a diversion, something to keep the screws occupied. Anyway, we'll think about that when we've got the rest arranged.
Look at this, Bee. That's Doreen's signature and that's mine. You can't tell them apart, can you?
It's not bad.
Very good.
Yeah. Well, we've got the money organised. All we have to worry about now is getting you some day clothes. Yeah.
What's going on here? Get back to work, the lot of you.
We're just talking about the pantomime, Vera. Oh, look, have you heard anything about the material for the costumes?
No, I haven't. Were you smoking, Birdsworth?
No, Miss Bennett.
Put it out. You can smoke during your break. You're revolting. Now, don't let me catch any of you wasting time again.
Is Helen going to get Doreen's money from the bank?
Yeah.
Jeez, I wouldn't trust her.
Oh, what do you think? She's taking your money now.
No, she wasn't on the inside when it was pinched, was she? But if she gets outside with Doreen's money, I wouldn't count on seeing either of them again.
Diversion's gonna have to be bloody good, especially with the screws wandering around with rifles.
Yeah. Hey, Judy, have you seen Lizzie?
No, she shot through after lunch. She said she was gonna study her lines for the panda. Hey, Bee, that reminds me, you know, I've been thinking about my ugly sister makeup. I've been thinking about basing it on a real-life person.
Oh, yeah, anyone we know?
I don't know if you know her or not, but she's got a face like a withered-up prune.
I think I know the one you mean.
Yeah?
You were getting out on bail.
Oh, that bitch Vera screwed it up. She told them the letter was from my brother, not from Megan.
Well, she'd know. She reads everything that comes into this joint. You should have thought of that before you tried it on.
I did not try it on. That envelope had two letters in it.
All right, love. You don't have to convince me. The cops are the ones you have to worry about. G'day, Helen. How are the, writing lessons going, all right?
Oh, eh? Real well, yeah.
Well, that's good. That means we've got one thing to worry about then, doesn't it?
And what's that, Bee?
That you might skip with the dough when you get out.
I wouldn't do that.
That's very wise, you see. Because seeing as how you're such a stupid cow, you're probably going to end up back in here anyway. And if you do and I find out you've crossed me, you are going to be very sorry.
I wouldn't. Honest.
Well, fine. Then we know we can trust you, don't we, Ju?
Yeah.
What I am worried about is how do I get any information back to you once I'm out?
Ah, well, we've thought about this. Come here, I'll show you.
What would Bee do to anyone who crossed her?
Depends on what they done.
The woman that bashed her, what would she do to her if she found out who it was?
No, I don't know. The last one to attack Bee was this screw called Yates. She stabbed Bee with a knife.
What happened to her?
She's dead.
Griffin still insists that that letter was from her friend Megan. Vera, are you sure she couldn't have made a mistake?
Of course not. She wrote it herself.
Well, why would she do that? I mean, she must have known she'd be caught out.
You're acting as if you believe her.
No, I didn't say that. I was just asking.
I think she's a troublemaker. You've seen her type before. She deserves everything that's coming to her, calling me a liar. I'm not surprised her friend Megan disappeared. Probably wants nothing to do with her.
That's if Megan exists at all.
What do you mean?
Well, the police haven't been able to find her, despite all their efforts. Now, if that letter is a forgery...
It is.
Well, then perhaps Anne made up Megan as well as the letter. Perhaps the whole thing is a figment of her imagination.
Oh, dear. I don't think me magic's strong enough. I think I need some help. Will you kids help me? You would? Good. Right. Now, when I say go, you all shout with me. Snakes and lizards, rats and feathers, grant this wish of Cinderella's. Right? Go. Snakes and lizards, rats and feathers, grant this wish of Cinderella's.
Oh, that's it. She's finally flipped.
God, you frightened the life out of me, B.
Now, what are you doing?
Oh, I'm practicing for the panto.
And what is the myth?
Oh, those are my ill pates. I'm going to be a learner fairy godmother.
Yeah, well, go and learn over in a corner somewhere. We want to talk to Margo.
Oh, good. I'll never get it right if you don't let me practice. I mean, even Sir Lawrence of Olivia had to practice.
Okay, Bev, make yourself scarce.
What's going on?
We want you and Bev to play tennis tomorrow morning.
What for?
Because I say so. That's what for. Helen's due for release, and there's some information we wanted to get for us.
What information do you want exactly?
Hey, Lizzie, why don't you go outside and practice? Anne, he'll give you a hand, won't you, Anne?
Oh, yeah.
Beauty! You can be Cinderella.
Oh, but I don't know the part.
Well, you can use the script because I know all the words.
The first thing you've got to do is go to the city council and get a plan of the stormwater drains.
How do I do that?
Well, just tell them you're from a building contractor and you want to know where to put the foundations.
Yeah, right. When you find out where it comes out, we want a truck parked there the day of the escape.
Yeah, and we'll need driver's licenses, but you can get them from the weasel.
Don't forget, I've already given him the $500, so you don't have to pay a thing. You just tell him to give you the driver's licenses or else.
Or else what?
Or else you tell the police that he helped me escape last time.
Or you get your pimp to bash you.
Oh, God, I wouldn't want to involve him. He'd end up pinching the weasel's money and Doreen's.
All right, well, you sort the details out for yourself. We just want those plans, the money, the truck, and the licenses.
Don't worry. They'll be there.
So you want to go to the princess party?
Yes, I do. But who are you?
I'm your fairy godmother.
I never knew I had a fairy godmother.
Well, you have.
Did I frighten you?
Oh, yeah, that's where I changed me costume. Did I frighten you?
You're silly doing this.
Oh, come on. We want to do it for the kids. Be nice doing it for the little kids. It's been a long time. You'd like to do it for your little kid.
Yes.
Where is she?
In Western Australia. I didn't want her around while all this was going on.
Oh, you got to make sure they give her back when all this is over. That's what happened to my kids. I never saw them again.
Oh, don't worry, I'll get Megan back.
Megan?
Yes, I named her after my friend.
Some friend who shot through on you when you was in trouble.
Oh, she'll turn up. But do you want to rehearse some more?
Oh, yeah. Where was I?
Did I frighten you?
Yeah.
Where are Judy and Doreen planning the escape?
What do you want to know for?
I'd like to help.
Oh, you don't want to get involved, especially as you know you're going to get out. You've got to think of your little girl.
Yes. Yes, you're probably right.
Oh, drat! I'm never going to get this rehearsal done.
Knew I had a fairy godmother.
Well, you have. Did I frighten you?
No, not really.
Drat! I never get to frighten anybody.
Why is it that you're wearing L plates?
I had a bit of trouble passing my fairy godmother tests. The last time the examiner asked me to turn him into a charming prince, but I turned him into a frog.
Who? Was he angry?
I don't know, my cat ate him. Oh. Hey, B, you want to have a go? I know all me words.
No, I'm trying to read this book. Someone has to figure out how to get Doreen out of here.
Well, you got to stop now anyhow.
Okay.
What were you up to, Dor?
I don't know. I can't see the page. There's no point in me rehearsing anyhow. I'm going to be out when the pantomime goes on, aren't I?
Is she, P?
I don't know. Unless you've let me finish this book in peace, I won't find out.
Do you still want to escape, Dor?
I don't know. I reckon if I don't get out this time, I never will. God knows how long I'm going to get for taking little Elizabeth. And when you're in here, things happen. I was only supposed to be in for 6 months the first time, and I've been in here for years. I could die in here.
I'm going to miss you, Dor.
I'm going to miss you too, Lizzie.
Get Smart's property, would you?
Oh, geez, you're not here to book me already, are you? I'm not at the door yet.
It won't be long, Smart. I'm here to see Griffin again.
Right.
I understand Griffin has made certain accusations against Miss Bennett.
She said she was mistaken, yes.
Well, if that's why you're here, I'd like to be present when you question her.
Fine.
Miss Bennett, when you finish with Smart, would you bring Griffin to my office, please?
Yes, Mrs. Davidson. Sign here.
Right, what are we waiting for?
There's no hurry. Like the officer says, you'll be back soon enough.
Graphology is a fairly exact science these days. It's pretty hard to fool the experts. And although there was a lot of superficial differences between the handwriting in the letter and the example you gave us, there's no doubt about it that they were written by the same person.
They weren't. That letter was from West Australia, from Megan.
We've still contacted the Western Australian police. They'll talk to your brother. No doubt he'll confirm what we already know.
Do you still insist that letter was written by Megan?
No.
I can't see what you hope to gain by all this. You were bound to be found out.
I just needed time. I know Megan will turn up sooner or later, but that might be too late.
If you wish to delay your trial, you should do it through your solicitor. I understand he's due to visit you tomorrow.
But that might be too late. I'm in danger.
In danger from what? Are you aware of any threats to Griffin, Miss Bennett?
No, Mrs. Davidson. It's just another one of her stories.
Well, unless you have any specific allegations to make, you will be returned to the other women, have you?
No.
Very well. But just remember, it won't help you at all to waste our time again.
I've just got this job with this architect, and he told me to come down here and get some plans for some stormwater drains. But the trouble is, I don't even know what a stormwater drain looks like. And I told him I was experienced.
I see. Well, what area are you looking for?
Well, I'm not sure.
Well, you must have an address.
Yeah, but I left it at the office. But it's near the Wentworth Detention Centre.
Oh, yeah, that vacant plot of land. Look, just a minute.
I'm really sorry to bother you like this. You must get awfully fed up with women sometimes. Are you married?
No. Is this the area?
I'm not sure. Is this the prison?
Yeah, that's the Wentworth Road.
Yeah, that must be the one. Can I get a copy of this?
I'll run you off one. Cost you $2.
Okay.
What are you doing here?
I've come to work. I'm taking Helen's place.
Oh, you don't have to work. Not when you're only on remand.
Oh, it's something to do. My trial could be months away yet. My family are sending me a lawyer, but, well, they haven't found Megan yet.
What about the letter she wrote you?
It was a forgery. I wrote it myself.
How come you didn't tell us that?
Well, you know, I thought someone might talk to the screws.
You trying to say one of us had lag?
Oh, well, that's possible, isn't it? Don't forget someone bashed you and set me up for those robberies.
That's right. And the same person might think of lagging.
And who might that be?
I don't know, B. But if I knew, I'd tell you.
Well, you'd better. Because I don't like things going on that I don't know about. They might just cut across my plans.
You mean the escape?
I mean the escape. And if I hear you mention it again, I'll ram one of those coat hangers down your throat.
I wouldn't say anything. I'd like to help. If they can't find Megan, I might need to get out myself.
And what's going on here? Griffin?
Nothing.
All right, everybody, outside. It's recreation. Not you, Griffin.
Now, what was going on?
I told you nothing.
That's the second time I found Smith practically standing over you. You told Mrs. Davidson you were in danger.
Oh, that was just something to say.
It might help us and you, Griffin, if you told the same story twice in a row. All right, outside.
Back already, Smart. What happened? Are you working the streets during the day now?
I haven't been arrested. I came back to get something that was pinched.
Who stole it?
One of you screws. A cigarette case. I had it when I came in and now it's gone.
You signed for everything when you left?
Yeah, well, I didn't check the list, did I?
Would you get Smart's property list, please?
Oh, g'day, Anne.
No talking, Griffin.
She been arrested again?
No, she's accusing us of stealing some of her property.
Come along, Griffin.
There's no cigarette case listed here.
Well, I had it.
It's not on the list when you signed in, and it's not on the list when you signed out. Obviously, you lost it somewhere else. I suggest you call the police. I'll escort Smart off the premises. Now, come on.
You were a bit hard on her, don't you think?
Maybe. I've been wondering about her and about you being set up and my bash on the head have all happened since she arrived.
You don't think she's responsible, do you?
Don't know yet. She didn't show much spine when I heavied her. Still, that could be an act.
What are you going to do with her?
Set her up. Involve her in something, and if the screws find out about it, then we'll know it's her.
Who did that?
Sorry, Miss Bennett, it was an accident.
I bet it was, Gaffney. Now, I'm going to be reporting this to the governor.
Ah, good shot, Margo.
Outside, Smart.
Looks like you're in trouble, Margo.
I can cope.
Give it back! Give it back! Unless you're playing, get out of the way.
That must be where the cellar connects up with the storm drain. See, it runs right down to the river.
Yeah.
What'd the note say?
That there'd be a truck waiting where the map was marked with a cross.
Oh, we're all set then.
Yep. All we have to worry about now is getting you four down that manhole. And hoping the screws don't find out.
Yes.
Oh, yes, Mr. Gillespie.
I've just received notification of your decision to have a pianist at the pantomime.
That's correct.
And this pianist will be visiting the prison three times in the preceding week.
For rehearsals.
Hmm. Do you think that's wise? I mean, musicians are such unreliable types. So many of them involved in the drug scene and so on.
Mrs. Hammond has been coming to Wentworth to accompany church services for as long as I can remember.
I'm sure she never takes anything more dangerous than a strong cup of tea.
Well, then there's the question of payment. I assume she will be paid.
Yes, from the recreation fund. That's set aside for craft materials, books, things like that. The women are prepared to forego that for a good cause.
What the women see as a good cause and what I see as one may not necessarily be the same. These are what I regard as the minimum security arrangements. As you can see, no one will be permitted to enter the prison buildings. There'll be a marquee set up in the garden, paid for from the recreation fund, and the entire prison staff will have to be on duty.
Well, they're not going to like that.
Probably not.
Well, what about the night shift afterwards? Obviously, they can't be on duty.
Well, they must. If necessary, they'll have to work split shifts. We're dealing with the safety of small children.
Mr. Gillespie, I realise you've had vast experience with men's prisons, but a women's prison is rather different. The women would never harm a child.
How can you say that with a woman like Doreen Burns in here? She was convicted of kidnapping an 11-month-old baby.
But... very well. I'll have new work rosters drawn up.
Thank you.
Oh, good day, Ted.
Good day, Mr. Jackson. Look, could you just wait a minute while I check if it's okay for you to come in?
But why?
It is Mr. Morris, isn't it?
Yeah.
It's ridiculous, these new security measures. Gillespie's making this place impossible.
Well, I suppose some of the inmates have always thought it was impossible.
Don't joke, Bob. I have to work here.
I'm not joking, and you don't have to work here. Ah, here we go.
You okay?
I think I'll just...
Hey, let me give you a hand there. That's quite a load you got on there.
You're rather late, Mrs. Jackson.
Well, yes, I've been shopping.
Shopping?
Yes, actually, I gave Mrs. Jackson permission to do some shopping. She's been buying some things for the pantomime.
Ah, I see. You must be Mr. Morris.
Yes, that's right.
Thank you for your help.
Oh, it's a pleasure.
Perhaps you'd escort Mr. Morris off the premises.
That won't be necessary. I know my way out.
Oh, we can't have you wandering round unescorted, Mr. Morris.
I'll pick you up after work, okay? From the outer gate.
Right.
Leave those, Mrs. Jackson. They'll have to be searched.
But surely you don't think I'd smuggle anything into the prison?
You weren't the only one carrying parcels in.
And neither would Bob.
One can't be too sure, Mr. Jackson. After all, his daughter is an inmate of one of our prisons. Make sure all these parcels are searched thoroughly, Mr. Fletcher.
Yes, sir.
Jackson, could you tell me where I could find Mr. Fletcher?
Yes, in reception.
What's wrong?
Gillespie, that's what's wrong. I've just spent the morning searching the city for cheap material for the pantomime, and when I get back here, he insists on having it searched for contraband. He also accused Bob of being unreliable.
Yes, I'm sorry. Mr. Gillespie has the interest of the prison at heart. He just has an unfortunate manner.
Yes, well, I've had it. It's the last thing I do for the pantomime.
Oh, I'm sure Mr. Gillespie will be glad to hear that.
Why, what do you mean?
He wants the pantomime cancelled. He probably thinks if he makes life difficult enough for us, we'll give up on the idea.
And will we?
Well, I'm not.
All right, then. Neither will I. I'll help. Although I sometimes wonder whether it's worth the trouble Gillespie and people like him cause.
Attention, ladies. The material for your pantomime costumes has arrived.
Oh, Butte, you want a hand bringing it in?
Won't be kept in here. They'll be kept in the storeroom, except when you're working on it.
Well, we should be working on it now. The panto's only a week away.
I'm sorry. All work's to be restricted to your recreation period. The dressmakers are to be locked in here. The rest of you will be in the recreation room.
Locked in?
To avoid rostering any extra staff.
Ah, to stop us from pinching stuff, you mean? Why would we want to pinch it when we practically paid for it with our own money?
I'm sorry, Smith, those are my orders.
Yeah, and I bet I know who set the order, too. Dizzy bloody Gillespie.
Just letting you hold this pantomime is a privilege. Obviously, there are going to be extra precautions taken. You're not the only ones involved. The staff are going to be involved in extra duties while the kids are here and while we're putting up the marquee.
Marquee?
Yes, the pantomime's to be held in the garden.
You mean they wouldn't even trust a few kids in the building?
Oh, of course not. I mean, they might steal something, mightn't they? Well, anything I've got there, welcome to.
Well, we got nothing to pinch anyway.
It's not the kids they don't trust, it's us. They probably think we'd hurt them.
That's where it's going to be held. Now, if you don't like the idea, we can always cancel the whole thing. But if you do decide to go ahead with it, you better decide who the dressmakers are going to be. There'll only be four of you allowed in here while you're working on it.
Rotten bastards!
Well, they sure know how to screw things up, don't they?
I'm not so sure. A marquee in the garden, near the manhole, a pantomime for a diversion. You are as good as out.
That's right.
You don't smile too much. The screws will think they're doing us a favour.
What's wrong with Doreen?
Poor little love. She's on remand too, for kidnapping a kid. It's that bloody Gillespie for reminding her. He ought to be put in there like Yatesy.
Yatesy? Isn't that the one who attacked B?
That's right.
What happened to her?
She suffocated in here. She was in there for days. Must have been a horrible death. Suffocating. Turning blue. Well, come on, love. Throw it in. The wet clothes. Throw them in the dryer.
I couldn't. I'd suffocate her.
She's not in there now. Good. She'd be a bit on the nose if she was.
Mr. Gillespie, I saw your security measures for the pantomime.
Yes?
They're very good. But there is one thing.
Hmm?
You haven't put any guards on the roof. From there, they'd have a complete view of the garden. They could make sure nothing went wrong, especially if they had rifles.
That's a very good idea, Miss Bennett. I'll incorporate that in the plan straight away.
With all those kids milling around, no one's going to know what's going on.
Well, I went to this panto once when I was a kid, and at the end, they all threw lollies at us. And you should have seen all the kids, you know, they're fighting and bashing and pushing each other around just to get at the lollies, you know?
That's a good idea.
What?
Well, we'll do the same. While the kids are fighting over the lollies, that'll be your chance to escape.
But Doreen and I'll still be on the stage.
I thought about that. We're going to make two sets of costumes. With your ugly sister mask and nose and your veil, who's going to know who's on stage for the finale?
Right.
All right, who's making the costumes today? Well, who else? Come on, you can have four people. You'll need them to get the job done. Leave those papers, Bryant. You're going to work.
Griffin said she'd give a hand. We need the papers to cut out the patterns. And the pantomime costumes. She said you'd help out.
Oh, yes.
Well, come on, get going.
If you're going to make two costumes for Jude and Dore, do you reckon Anne can be trusted?
Well, we'll soon find out.
There you are, ladies. I'll be back to pick you up in 2 hours when it's time to go back to your cells.
Okay.
Right. Get your shirt off.
What?
Well, you want to help with the escape plan, don't you?
Oh, yes.
Good. But... well, get your shirt off. Come on. That's a girl. Is that comfy?
Yeah.
Try not to let anyone see this, right? Good. Good. Okay.
All clear.
Right, girls. Let's get to work, huh?
You're spoiling me.
Well, that's a general idea. After a long day at Wentworth, you deserve it. Especially putting up with that Mr. Gillespie of yours.
Thanks. Yes, he is a bit of a pain, isn't he? The thing is, he doesn't want the pantomime to go on. So he's making life as difficult as possible for everyone.
Well, I would have thought he'd have had the authority simply to stop it.
Well, apparently not. Erica's got departmental backing. Poor Erica. She's tried for years to make Wentworth progressive, And he comes along with his armed guards and karate lessons. I don't know how anyone can carry on like that.
He's probably got nothing better to do. Is he married?
Oh, I've no idea.
You know, he and Vera would make a good pair.
Bob?
I mean it. They probably spend their honeymoon doing night shifts at Wentworth.
Oh, Bob, Vera isn't that bad.
No, well, I wouldn't want her on my honeymoon.
No. Trouble is, they'll both be there when I go back.
Then don't go back.
Bob, we have discussed this before.
I know, but things have changed. I mean, I don't see how you still think you can be helping the women when the place is being turned into a madhouse. You said yourself it's become unbearable.
But if I leave, it'll become even more unbearable. What about Erica? Without the support from me and people like me, she'll be on her own.
And what happens if she leaves?
Well, she wouldn't.
Or is replaced. Where would that leave you?
There we go. Here we are.
You all right, Griffin? I asked if you're all right.
Yes.
You on any medication from the sister? Any drugs?
No.
I think you better go and see her then.
I'm all right.
You're sweating.
Oh. Well, she's been helping me, you know, at the press iron and things as I cut them out. Anyway, she's probably not used to hard work coming from a rich family and all.
Is that right, Griffin?
Yes.
Look, if you're still sweating in the morning, put yourself on sick call. Go and see the sister, okay? All right, put all those materials onto the trolley. It's being locked away for the night. Scissors. There's stuff you're working on too, Phyllis. Come on, haven't got all night. Is that all there is? I thought there was more.
Oh, well, we had a few false starts, you see.
Oh, well, if you waste this lot, don't forget that's all there is. There isn't any more.
Where's the material?
Anne, the material?
I'll make a good pair of pants for you, Doreen. Jude, you measure her up and cut them out, but you can sew them up yourself. The rest of us will carry on as you.
Vera!
Griffin, come with me. You're wanted.
But
now!
Jude, get the material out of the dryer and hide it somewhere outside the laundry.
Yeah, but what about Doreen's pants?
Look, if she's gonna lag, now's the time she's gonna do it.
Don't you think she would have lagged already if she was?
Will you just get rid of it?
I've been retained by your family to handle your case. And to be quite honest, Miss Griffin, it's not going to be easy, even though it's your first offence. Robbery with violence is too serious an offence for you to expect anything less than a jail sentence.
But Mr. Potter said he thought I could get off.
That was when he expected Megan Evans to give evidence. Unfortunately, there's no trace of her.
Don't my family know where she is?
They've never heard of her.
Oh, that's impossible.
Miss Griffin, I'm only telling you what your brother told me. The only Megan they've ever heard of is...
They want me to go to jail. That's it, isn't it? That's why you're here. You're not trying to get me off. You want to get me locked up and safely out of the way.
Miss Griffin, I assure you, your brother is only trying to help.
Liar! He just wants to keep all the money for himself. He's never wanted me to have any.
Miss Griffin.
Liar!
Is everything all right, Mr. Collins?
Yes, thank you. Sit down, please, Anne.
Call me if you need me. I'll be right outside.
Thank you. As I was saying, the only Megan your brother knew was your daughter. And you know she's been dead for several years.
Officer Knox, I've just been working on the rosters for the day of the pantomime. I was wondering if you'd mind patrolling on the roof on that day.
On the roof?
Yes, Gillespie wants some officers with rifles up there.
You're joking.
No, he's serious. They'll have a better overall view of the garden.
Well, I can understand that. But with rifles, there'll be children here.
I know, that's why I want somebody level-headed up there.
Oh, it's just insane.
Look, Meg.
Well, I wouldn't be there. This place is turning into a madhouse. You can't have rifles when there are children around. Accidents happen.
I've got my orders.
Well, thank God I won't be here. Excuse me.
Well, I hope you don't feel that way about it. Somebody's got to do it. I'm sure there won't be any trouble.
As you can see, if we put the marquee here, the view of the fence behind would be completely obscured from the ground, but from the roof.
Come in.
Mrs. Davidson, can I have a word with you, please?
Well, I'm afraid it will have to wait, Mrs. Jackson, unless it's urgent. I'm just going over security arrangements for the pantomime with Mr. Gillespie.
That's why I want to talk to you. I understand you're having armed guards on the roof.
That's correct.
In that case, I resign. I won't be back after my honeymoon.
Perhaps we could talk about this a little later, Mrs. Jackson.
I'm sorry, Mrs. Davidson, I've made up my mind. I've worked here because I thought I could help these women, but you don't help anybody by shooting them or by making their lives so unbearable that they become even more antisocial. I'm sorry, I resign. Better I leave it to those who enjoy playing God.
Obviously pre-wedding nerves. Understandable after the way her first husband died.
You're not looking any better, Griffin. Did you see the sister?
She looks as if she's on drugs to you.
No, I don't think that's her problem. I just overheard her talking to her solicitor. Apparently her family have never heard of this Megan character. She's made the whole thing up. Now she's been caught out.
Yeah, well, that could be it. But she was looking a bit strange last night. Keep an eye on her, will you?
Right.
Oh, look, I'd like a word with you if you've got a minute.
What about?
The pantomime. You know how the women feel about guns. None of them want to go up on the roof.
They'll just have to.
What are you saying, Griffin?
They've killed her. B. Shut her in the dryer. She'll be dead.
In the dryer,
by now.
In the laundry.
Yes.
Come on, Griffin.
Out of the way, Lizzie.
There you go, Mr. Fletcher. I'm an old woman.
Did you find anything, Mr. Fletcher?
No.
I thought so. Another of your stories, Griffin.
She was in there. Megan was in there. They've killed her.
Outside, I'll teach you to waste our time.
Well, that settles it, doesn't it? She is a lag.
I think it's more serious than that. Did you see her face? She really thought there was a body in there. She's as nutty as a fruitcake. And she knows all our escape plans.